amazing, so amazing. Your love for us is overwhelming. How awesome is our God.
Oh my God, I got two more and I'm going to let you go. And so it's the power of God, my brothers and sisters, that not only, amen, gives you, amen, the ability to fulfill purpose or to overcome or to withstand, but it is the power of God that gives you the ability of expectation. How many expecting something? Y'all don't sound like it. Let me say again. How many of y'all expecting something? It's the power of God that gives you the ability of expectation. Jeremiah 29:11 says, "For I know the thoughts that I think towards you." He said, saith the Lord. He said, thoughts of peace and not of evil to give you an expected end. I have an expectation that things are going to get better. Tell somebody, I have an expectation that things are going to get better. Oh my God. God, let me say it again. Tell your neighbor on the other side there. Say, neighbor, I have an expectation that things are going to get better. I know we fake it in the church like we got it going on. Like, come on here, somebody. I know how it is, amen. But every now and then, my expectations need to be lifted up, amen. My expectations need to be strengthened, amen. And it's the power of God that enables me, amen, to lift my expectations, amen. Can I get a witness in here? It's the power of God that helps me and enables me to say it's got to get better because I'm expecting more from God. Shake another neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm expecting more from God. My final point, my brothers and sisters, is that God's power, it is God's power that give you the ability to resurrect some stuff that look like is dead. Lazarus, come forth. I don't know what your Lazarus might be, but you have power. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, you have the power, if you don't doubt God, to raise up every dead thing. Finances in your church, you have the power to raise it up. As I close, my brothers and sisters, there was a lady who lived out in the boondocks. She did not have electricity, but she wanted it. She called the electric company and they made arrangements so that they could run lines and could get her the benefits of electricity. After delivering electricity to her home for almost 6 months, someone at the company noticed that only one unit of electricity was used. A serviceman was sent out to check and to make sure there was no problems. He rang the doorbell, and when she answered, he asked, "Hello, miss, are you using your electricity?" She said, "Why, yes, I am." He said, "May I ask what you're using it for?" "Well, when it gets dark," she said, "I turn it on long enough for me to light my kerosene lamp." The problem is, my brothers and sisters, this woman didn't understand the power that she had. She had all the power that could keep things well lit all night long. but she was selling for a kerosene existence. Sound like the church, doesn't it? This is the same issue with many of us, many Christians and believers today. We're selling for taking this great power that God has given us only to light our human efforts and not maximize the power of God's existence. You got to know, my brothers and my sisters, that we have been granted access to an awesome power. And we've got to use this power. Hunch on your neighbors and neighbor, we got to use this power. The overtone of our text today sounds like a doxology, because Paul says, now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh within us. There is a breakthrough, my brothers and my sisters, in the doxology. A doxology is a liturgical expression to praise God. It comes from the Hebrew derivative doxo. A doxo is an opinion after you've had a circumstance. Is an opinion after something has come against you. Can I get a witness in here? Yes, my brothers and sisters, you can never give a benediction until you've had a challenge. Can I get a witness in here? A doxology is what? Amen. You put on the end of a thing after it was not able to take you through. It is what you say after the situation has not been able to be completed. It did come. Tell somebody, it did come. Sickness came. Can I get a witness in here? Problems came. Can somebody testify? Situations came against you. It did come. Touch your neighbors and neighbor, it did come. But it was not able to do. Did you get that? I said, it did come, but it was not able to do. It is an opinion, my brothers and sisters, that after you've dealt with a challenging situation, I want to give you a personal opinion. I've seen some personal attacks. Has anybody here ever seen some personal attacks? Some things came against you. Circumstances rose up. The vicissitudes of life, they begin to knock on your door. The unexpected shifts and changes, they came your way. Who would have thought, amen, Michael White, former athlete, never had any sicknesses, never been in the hospital, always had a good bill of health. Who would have thought, amen, there would have been a personal attack that the devil would bring upon me? I have some personal attacks in my life, but now, unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that I can ask or even think, Tell your neighbors, oh neighbor. Come on, tell us, oh neighbor. I don't know what you're facing. I really don't know how long you've been facing it. But I do know God. Tell them, I know God. God is able. So my brothers and my sisters, whatever you do, don't doubt God's power. Shake a neighbor, say, neighbor, I will not doubt the power of God, because power works on the inside of me. Is there anybody here? You have power. But the Bible says in Acts 1:8, after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, you shall receive power. Is there anybody here? You have the Holy Ghost. I'm not just talking about any Holy Ghost, but you have power working on the inside. Shake a neighbor on the other side and say, oh neighbor, I have power working in me. I don't know about you, my brothers and my sisters, but I made up my mind that I'm gonna use my power. Yes, my brothers and my sisters, the Bible says, thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is he that giveth thee power to get wealth. Yes, but the Bible says, hallelujah to the Lamb of God. The Bible says, to us, my brothers and my sisters, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers. Yes, but I like what the Bible says in the text, amen, though we wrestling against these principalities. Shake another neighbor and say, neighbor, we still have power to overcome. Yes, we do. We have power. So the Bible says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Shake somebody and say, oh, neighbor, I'm going to be strong in the Lord that I serve, because power is working in me. I don't know about you, but I made up my mind. I'm going back to my church and use my power. Is there anybody here? You're going to use your power. I'm not doubting that God is able. Yeah. High five a neighbor and say, neighbor, I don't know about your God, but my God, he's an able God. He's able to heal. He's able to deliver. He's able to make a way. Say yeah. Say yes. Say yeah. Say yeah. I got to leave y'all, but I'm glad. Is anybody glad? You have power working in you. Oh my God. I said, are you glad? You have power working in you. Shake five people and say, neighbor, use your power. Use the power of the Lord.